Hi everyone, and welcome to the next lecture, which will be on static files and images. So let's get straight to it. So first of all, we need to configure our static files in Django. So to do that, the first thing we want to do is we just want to create a folder under our project. So our project here is called Taskly, so we can just right click, say new folder, and we need to just say static. So make sure that this is under your base directory or your root directory, very important. So make sure you have a similar structure to mine here. Next, we want to go ahead and create three subfolders for our static files. So some examples of our static files will be, for example, CSS files. So we can create a subfolder called CSS, create another one called JS for JavaScript, and we'll create a third one that is for our images. Okay, so we will have under our static folder directory here, we'll have our CSS folder, images folder, and JS folder for what we require. Okay, next we need to actually go ahead and set this up. So we need to go to our project here, head over to settings.py, and what we need to do is we need to configure this line here. So as you see here, I have listed two messages here for you. So you can either choose to select this method, which is the newer one, or you can go ahead and use the second method here. So I will explain what these do. So this method here, static files does. Okay, so this basically is to let Django know about the static folder. Okay, so we utilize the static URL to tell us, and then we join it with our base directory as well. So we want to say, hey, Django, look in our base directory, which is here, for static, which is here. Okay, so this is what the method does. Okay, you can also choose to use this second method, especially which is helpful if you're using older versions of Django. So it does the same thing. It just utilizes the OS module and just a little bit longer. So of course we're telling Django, hey, look in the base directory for the static folder. Okay, so be sure to just add this line here of your code. Okay, so just in case, I'm just gonna retype it again just so you guys are aware so you don't forget. So it will be static files underscore dir. And then here, remember to open it up with square brackets, and you can just say base dir and then slash static. Okay, so I'm just retyping it so you guys can actually just remember to type this in. Okay, so that's what you need to add. Just add this line here. Okay, so now we will have Django configured and set with our static files. Okay, perfect. Now, what we need to do next. So now we want to configure and connect CSS. Okay, so to do that, we just want to go to our static folder in CSS, and we just want to create a new file. So we're just going to create an external CSS file, and I'm going to call it styles.css. So very simple. Okay, within this CSS file, I'm going to add some very simple logic. So I just want to see which template I want to use it on. So let's say on a manipulate index.html. And I have a h2 tag here that I want to manipulate. I just want to change this color here to red. Okay, so keep it very simple. So all I'm going to do is just say h2. So I'm just using very basic CSS here. And I'm just going to say color, and I'm going to say blue. So very simple. So of course, when this CSS file is integrated here, and we refresh, this text here will be in blue. Okay, very simple. Now, the question that you're wondering is, how do we get this external CSS file loaded up in index.html, okay? So to do that, we need to add a tag here called load static, and I'll explain in a minute what that is for. Okay, so load static, okay, this is basically telling Django that we want to use static files in our template. So that's why we use this tag here. So we'll be able to use anything here, so CSS, images, or JS, anything. So make sure that you add this whenever you want to integrate your static files. Okay, next we need to actually reference this styles.css page here. So to reference that, we're going to kind of link it, all right? But before we do that, I just want us to utilize good standards here because this doesn't look great. So since we're using HTML, we need to obviously just say HTML here. Okay, very simple. And I'm just going to add some code here just to make this cleaner. I'm going to indent it a little bit as well. Okay, and I'm going to add a head tag here. Okay, and of course the head tag is usually for any metadata or any sort of external links that you plan on putting in your HTML file. Okay, so this is good practice to follow this. And I'm just going to say here link rel, and I'm going to put in here style sheet, because that's what we're technically using, a style sheet. The type, of course, would be of text forward slash CSS. And then we're going to add a href attribute. And this tag is going to be a little bit unique. So we're going to put a tag again with that percentage symbol. Oh. And it's going to be called static, because first of all, we're going to look in the static folder. So we can go ahead and say static. Then in quotes here, we need to say where we're going. So I want to go to static. Then I want to go to CSS. Then I want to go to styles.css. So in here, I'll reference the folder, which is CSS forward slash by the file, which is styles.css. And remember to add the extension there, .css. And there we go. So all we need to do now is close this up. And that's it. So this is how we would configure and connect CSS in Django. Now, we actually want to test this to see if it actually works. So let's get our server, check our server. So I just want to restart it and set it online again. Okay, no issues. That looks great. So let's go back and let's refresh. And there we go. So we can now see that CSS has been linked and everything to my index.html since the color has changed to blue. And that was configured in the styles.css file here. Okay, so that's it on CSS. All right, so the next thing that I want us to do is to configure and connect a JavaScript file externally. So we're just going to go to JS here, and we're going to create a simple JavaScript file. So I'm going to call it app.js. Okay, and I'm going to go in here, and I'm just simply going to say alert, and say welcome to my website. Okay, and add a semicolon there. So very simple JavaScript code. So this is just going to prompt an alert box when we refresh our page. So when we first access our page. So usually with JavaScript code, we need to reference the link. Remember, we have load static, so we're all okay. So we need to just say script, and we can say source. And it's going to be the same logic here that we use for our CSS referencing. So we're going to reference JavaScript the same way. The only difference is we're using a script tag here. Okay, and you don't need to put anything in between the script tags. So we can check here. Okay, so we're looking under static, under the JS folder. So we can say here, under the JS folder here, and the file name will be app.js. So here I can say app.js. Okay, so there we go. Let's see what's going to happen. So we're going to see an alert that says, welcome to my website. On our index.html page, we've referenced it here. We've loaded static. So let's give this a try. And if we refresh, I'm going to say, welcome to my website. So we can now see that JavaScript has indeed been configured to our index.html template. Let's try this again and refresh, and we can see it again. Perfect. Okay, so that's it on a JavaScript. Okay, so let's move on to the last part, and that is how do we configure and connect an image? All right. So first of all, I am going to keep this tag here for JavaScript, but I am going to comment this out for the alert. Okay, the reason being, I don't want to see this the whole time, so you can go ahead and do that. Okay, so now what I want to do is I want to below, I can put it here. I just want to add some breakpoints. I want to see, okay, I'm going to add a little bit more because I want to put my image around here. Okay, that's fine. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is I am going to upload an image to my static directory under my image folder. So let me do that. Okay, so I have a cat picture here, so I can drag it into images. So it's called cat1. So here's my nice cat, cat1.jpg. And what we can do is very simple. As long as we have load static, we can go ahead. So it's called cat1.jpg. Remember, it is case sensitive. So we can just use the image tag here called image, and we can say source. And I'm going to use that same tag, just like we've been using the whole time. And of course, I'm going to just close tag here. Oh, Okay, we can just close it like that. And I'm going to reference it, so it will be under images. So let's do the process. Under static, images, cat1. Static, images, and the file name is called cat1. So cat1.jpg with jpg. Okay. So let's actually see our cat. So this might maximize the screen, but that's not a problem. We will fix that in a moment. So let's refresh. And there's our cat. Nice. So this is how we would configure and connect an image in Django. So we just want to fix this up a little bit. Right, so let's add our inline CSS here. So I'm going to say style, and I'm just going to set the width here to 200 pixels. Okay, just like that. So if we go back to our cat, okay, we'll see this looks more appropriate. Okay, so basically that's it. So we've learned how to configure and connect an image. Okay, so let's close this up. So what we've learned, of course, is how to configure our static files to work with Django, how to connect everything. We've also learned how to configure and connect our CSS files, our JavaScript files, and even an image. Okay, so you've learned quite a lot, and I hope it helped you. Okay, so that's it.